Those sharks are nice. They don't bite. Yeah. Come on, let's go sing the sharks.
Now we do have lots of divers in here, and it looks like we have a feeding session going on right now. So we are scattered in different areas of this exhibit so that we can feed different animals. Now, these environments are better known as kelp forests, and kelp forests cover the entire coastline of California. They're usually found in cold, nutrient-rich waters, which is what we have in our ocean backyard. In these environments, you're of course gonna find a forest full of kelp, and that's gonna be that seaweed you see inside. That seaweed has some special adaptations that allow it to survive the way that it does. Starting at the bottom of this environment, you will find lots and lots of animals, but on that kelp structure, you're gonna find a really large brown algae. So because it's an algae, it means lots and lots of animals are going to eat it. There's not many animals that are going to eat it. So those giant sea bass have some spots on their bodies because they will sneak through the kelp so that they can get closer to the unsuspecting prey. Looking at some other prey.
Starfish? You see the starfish up there with me?
Sounds like we're in here.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Now, if you're new to the touch, tell me, do you want to make sure that you have your belly fat raised that you can actually touch upstairs on the second floor? And if you do get a chance to go upstairs, you'll notice a temperature difference. So this temperature pains.
That feels a lot different. Abby,
if you have any questions about anything you see here, please let me know. For those of you who are just joining us, you can also use two fingers as stencils as you can as we explore our animals. The best way to reach in is to lay down on your belly so that you can get the most optimal reach, and it'll put so if you can see that tiny circular animal right over there, walking along that edge, that animal is called a horseshoe crab. And that animal is actually not a crab. They're actually more closely related to spiders and scorpions. They travel on shores to have their lay their eggs. They're going to be eating small, tiny animals when they're hunting for their food. Some of the other animals that you'll see here are our cow nose rays. So if you can spot the rays that have an all brown color to their body, you can actually see that we have a variety of them in our pools. And if you get the chance to see the underside, we actually have a really awesome diagram right in front of that water plate area. You can learn about the distances.
Oh, Well, I mean, it was a bit smaller, but it was kind of big. I'm gonna go take Hi.
All right.
scared them away.
No, there it goes.
My God, that's so cool.
Wow.
Thank you.
never move on the spot?
My spot.
How many students don't you have?
Thank you.
Adiós, Okay. a lot of love. Like the bad the lunch that we're
hanging
out.
They're made out of layers.
Wow,
that's a lot.
Over there, right, Amy?
Yeah.